At different stages of a river's course, erosion and deposition give rise to different landforms. High mountain rivers cut down into land surfaces as the river puts almost all its energy towards cutting down to base level. This carves out deep V-shaped valleys and gorges. Tiger Leaping Gorge, for example, is one of the world's deepest, having been carved out by the Jinsha River. As a river cuts its deep V-shaped valley in its upper course, it follows the path of the easiest rock to erode. Thus, it tends to wind its way along, leaving the more resistant areas of rock as interlocking spurs. When a river runs over alternating layers of hard and soft rock, rapids and waterfalls may form. Often, a waterfall will form where a band of harder rock lies over a softer rock layer. As the stream bed gets steeper, the velocity of the stream also increases, thereby increasing the stream's erosive power. Eventually, the river's slope becomes vertical, leading to the formation of a waterfall. The base where the waterfall lands is called a plunge pool. Soft rock layers directly under the hard rock is undercut, creating an overhang. Once the overhang is big enough, the whole thing collapses due to gravity and its own weight. Another feature common near mountainous regions are braided rivers. This is where the river exhibits numerous channels that split off and rejoin each other, giving it a braided appearance. Braided rivers usually carry coarse sediment down a reasonably steep gradient. Water discharge tends to be highly variable in braided rivers. Meanders occur in the middle and lower course of a river where it is beginning to cut laterally as it gets closer to base level. Meanders are bends in the river where the faster water on the outside of the bend has cut into the bank, eroding it and creating a river cliff. The slow-moving water on the inside of the bend deposits its load, building up a slip-off slope. Meanders migrate downstream as they cut through the valley sides. Over time, lateral erosion cuts into the meander, causing the bends to become closer together. Eventually, the force of the river breaks through, and since this is the easiest path for the water to travel, the old meander no longer has as much water flowing through it. The river quickly deposits material along the side of its new course, which cuts off the old meander. The cut-off part of the old meander is called an oxbow lake. In the lower course of a river, the river has a high volume and a large discharge. The river channel is now deep and wide, and the landscape around it is flat. However, as a river nears its mouth, energy levels are low and deposition takes place. This creates a range of deposition features. A floodplain is the area around the river that is covered in times of flood. When rivers flood, they deposit alluvium, thus making the floodplain very fertile and excellent for agriculture. For example, the plains surrounding the Yulong River are places of abundance. A buildup of alluvium on the banks of a river can create levees, which raise the riverbank. They form during times of flood, where the river deposits its heaviest material closest to the normal course of the river. Deltas are found at the mouth of large rivers, such as the Pearl River Delta. The meeting of a river with a sea or a lake causes the river to lose energy and deposit its load. If this deposition takes place faster than the sea can remove it, a delta will form. There are three main types of delta. An arcuate or fan-shaped delta. The land around the river mouth builds out into the sea and the river splits many times on the way to the sea, creating a fan effect, such as the Nile Delta of Egypt does. A cuspate delta. The land around the river mouth just juts out like an arrow into the sea. A bird's foot delta. The river splits on the way to the sea. Each part of the river just juts out into the sea, resembling a bird's foot. For example, the Mississippi River Delta.
Ha ha ha!